friends. I'm so happy to see you today. I have something to show you. Do you see this? It is a special pumpkin that's been sitting right by my front door all of the month of November. It has a fancy letter A on the front. Do you see that? That stands for my last name, Akers. This pumpkin is really special to me because it has an A on it. It reminds me to be thankful for my family. And it was a gift from a friend, so it reminds me to be thankful for my friends too. And you are my friends, so I'm really thankful for each of you. November is a great time to remember things we're thankful for, and later, Miss Marlowe is going to teach you all about that. But first, Miss Caroline and Miss Lauren are coming to sing our November song with you right now. It's always fun when they join us, so everybody stand up and get ready to sing with my friends.
God made me and he loves me so, and he is my friend forever. God made me and he loves me so, and he is my friend forever. And it makes me jump up high, fall down low, spin around in a circle, run, run fast and walk, walk slow, stop, lift my hands and shine. God made me and he loves me so, and he is my friend forever. God made me and he loves me so, and he is my friend forever. And it makes me jump up high, fall down low, spin around in a circle, run, run fast, walk, walk slow, stop, lift my hands and shine. God made me and he loves me so, and he is my friend forever. God made me and he loves me so, and he is my friend forever. And it makes me jump up high, fall down low, spin around in a circle, run, run fast, walk, walk slow, stop, lift my hands and shine. You shine, let's sing it one more time. God made me and he loves me so, and he is my friend forever. God made me and he loves me so, and he is my friend forever. And it makes me jump up high, fall down low, spin around in a circle, run, run fast, walk, walk slow, stop, lift my hands and shine. And it makes me jump up high, fall down low, spin around in a circle, run, run fast, walk, walk slow, stop, lift my hands and shine.
That was great singing, guys. That song makes me so happy. Wasn't it fun to sing? Okay, now it's time for our November memory verse. Who's been practicing? Can you say hi to my friend, Miss Angela? She's coming to practice with you right now. Hi, Miss Angela. Hi, friends. I'm so glad to do our memory verse with you today. Are you ready? I want you to stand up with me and show me what you know. Are you ready? Okay, the words are, but God, we're going to point up, shows his love, cross your fingers over like, or your hands over like a big heart, for us, in that while we were still sinners, make an ugly face because sin is ugly, and then we put our arms out like Jesus, Christ died for us. It's in Romans 5:8. Let's go over that again. Are you ready? Okay. But God shows his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Romans 5:8. Let's do that one more time. Are you ready? But God shows his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Romans 5:8. Great job, guys. Keep practicing at home and we'll see you next time. Wow, guys, you've really been practicing. You did such a good job on our November Bible verse. Now, I'm really thankful that God gave us his words in the Bible. It's fun to learn them, and do you know what? I bet God has a big smile on his face when he listens to you memorizing his words. Let's take a minute to say thank you to God right now for all the blessings he's given us. Will you sing with me? Let me see your ready fingers. 3, 2, 1. God our Father, God our Father, we thank you. We thank you for our many blessings in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Great job, guys. Okay, it's time for our lesson. So I want you to reach up high and touch the sky. Reach down low and touch your toes. Everybody turn around. Now sit down. Great. All right, my friend Miss Marlowe is coming to teach you more about being thankful. I know she has something really special to show you. Do you want to see it? Okay, here she comes. Everybody turn on your listening ears and say, hey, Miss Marlowe.
Hi, friends. I'm so glad you're here today. And I have a little question for you. Did anybody celebrate Thanksgiving last week? Raise your hand. Did you celebrate Thanksgiving? I did. What did you eat? Tell me some of your favorite things that you ate last week for Thanksgiving. Oh, I like that one. Yes. Oh, yes, that too. My favorite thing, really, I have two favorite things. My two favorite things are ham and sweet potatoes. And you know what? I got to eat both of them last week. They were so yummy. I'm so thankful for Thanksgiving. Aren't you thankful for Thanksgiving? You know what? When we sit together for Thanksgiving, you know what we like to do? We like to talk about things we're thankful for. We talk about things that we're thankful that our family gave us. We talk about things that we're thankful that God gave us. And you know what? That's what our whole day is about. We're talking about being thankful. So we're going to tell God thank you for things today and learn about all the things that God gives us. Now, I have a special bear, okay? Now, I don't have a name for this teddy bear, but it's really special to me. I got it for Christmas last year, and it's made from a shirt that my dad used to wear. So it's like a shirt like this, but my dad used to wear it, and now it's made into a bear. And you know where it sits every day? It sits on my bed every day. So I always see it, and I have a little piece of that with me all the time, and I'm so thankful for it. All right, so we're gonna learn about being thankful from this book. Just like I'm thankful for my gift of the bear, we're gonna learn from this book. Do you know what this book is? That's right, it's the Bible. So what do we know about the Bible? The Bible is God's word. The Bible is always true. And the Bible is always right. Good job. Okay, we're gonna open our Bible up. We're going over here to the New Testament. Okay, and this is in the book of 1 Corinthians. And this guy named Paul, he's not just talking, he's actually writing a letter to some people. He's writing a letter to the people in Corinth. And he's telling them all these things. He goes, yeah, you have been doing such a good job. You're doing a good job of telling people about Jesus. And I know it's hard, but you're doing a good job. And I want you to keep going. Keep trying. Because God is giving you the way to do it. Okay? God gives us the ability. He gives us the strength and power to tell people about Jesus. And that's what Paul is telling these people. You have the power. Even when it's hard, like, oh, what if you're walking a long way? And you gotta walk and walk, you're like, Mommy, I'm tired. I don't wanna go anymore. But Mommy says, you know what? We're almost there. Let's keep going. So you walk some more and you're like, Mommy, I'm tired. I don't wanna walk anymore. Mommy's like, that's okay. You can do it. We're almost there. Well, that's kind of what this was like. That's what Paul was saying. Some of these things are hard. Some of these things that are happening to you aren't easy, but God gives you the power and the strength to move forward and to do the hard things. Can you guys show me your muscles? Let me see those muscles. When you have muscles and you're strong, we can do the hard things. And that's kind of what God was doing. He was giving them the strength to do the hard things and to keep going. So who helps us do the hard things? God does. That's right. So all through this, God is faithful. He fulfills his promises and he takes care of us. He helps us to stay strong and do the hard things even when we don't want to. But you know what? That's where we get to stop and say, thank you, God. Thank you. Thank you for making us strong. Thank you for helping us keep doing those things when they're hard. And you know what? I think we might need to just stop and say thank you right now and tell God thank you for all those things. All right, let me see some ready fingers. Ready? 1, 2, 3. God, we thank you so much that you love us. We thank you that you take care of us. We thank you for our families and for our church, for our friends. God, we thank you that even when things are hard, you still make a way for us and you give us strength to move forward and do things and to tell people about Jesus. We love you. In your name we pray. Amen. All right, guys, I've got some questions I'm going to ask you, okay? Are you ready for this? First one, who is it that calls us to tell others about Jesus? Was it Paul? Well, Paul told the Corinthians, but it's God. God is the one who calls us to tell others about Jesus. Okay, who gives us the ideas and the ability? Like, who gives us the power to tell people about Jesus? It's God. That's right. Now, who is always faithful? That means who always keeps their promises. God does. Yes, God does that. Now, who keeps us strong when we have to do the hard things? Can you show me those muscles? Strong. Who keeps us strong? God keeps us strong. Good job. Okay, one more question. Who do we want to thank for all these good gifts that keep us strong and that are faithful? Who do we want to thank for those things? You got it. It's God. We always want to thank God for everything. That's right. All right. On the count of three, we're going to say, thank you, God. But I want you to say it really, really quiet. Okay. Shh. 1, 2, 3. Thank you, God. Good job. Now we're going to say, thank you, God, in our regular voices. All right. Our regular inside voices. Thank you, God, on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Thank you, God. All right, great. Now then, are you ready? Third time, we're going to say it as loud as we can. I want you to make sure that somebody else hears you say this. Ready? So we're going to say thank you, God, on the count of three in our really loud voices. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Thank you, God! Yeah, good job, guys. I hope you have a great week. And remember, tell God thank you for everything he's given you. Bye.
Wow, thank you for that lesson, Miss Marlowe. Wasn't that a special teddy bear that Miss Marlowe has? What a good gift someone gave her. Can you think of something that you're really thankful for? Tell me about it. Wow, that really is something to be thankful for. This week, I want you to gather your mom, dad, maybe brothers or sisters, and I want you to pray with them and tell God thank you for what he's blessed you with. Can you do that? I know you can. Well, friends, that's all the time we have for today, but I'm going to see you right back here next week. And I want you to remember, you can go to clifec.com/parents and click on the links to find a craft and other activities to go along with what we talked about today. I hope you have a great week and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.